Now, students, with the continuation of the last lesson, we have differentiated the sine hyperbolic inverse. Similarly, the derivative of other inverse hyperbolic function can also be proved. For example, d by dx of cos hyperbolic x will be equal to 1 over under root x square minus 1, where x mod is greater than 1. Similarly, d by dx of tangent hyperbolic inverse of x is equal to 1 over 1 by 1 minus x square, where x mod is less than 1. Similarly, d by dx of secant hyperbolic inverse of x is equal to 1 minus 1 over x into under root 1 minus x square, where 0 is less than x is less than 1. Similarly, d by dx of cosecant hyperbolic inverse of x is equal to minus 1 dividing by x into 1 plus x square, whereas x is greater than 1, and equals 1 over 1 minus x square, as x mod is greater than 1. Now let us solve the examples of derivative of different types of functions. For example, example 1, find the derivative of x raised to the power x. Let y is equal to x raised to the power x, then taking the logarithm on both sides, we get log of y is equal to log of x raised to the power x. Then it will implies that log of y will be equal to x log of x. We have used the definition that log of x to the power x will be equal to x log of x. Now differentiating both sides with respect to y, we will get here d by dx of log to the base e of y is equal to d by dx of x log x. By taking the differential of log of y, we get 1 over y into dy over dx will be equal to x into d by dx of log of x plus, because it is the the product of two functions. So first function into derivative of the second plus second into derivative of the first. So by taking the derivative of log of x, here x will remains x, and the derivative of log of x will be equal to 1 by x, and plus log of log to the base e of x into derivative of x is 1. Now this x is cancelled by this x. Now 1 over y into dy over dx will be equal to 1 plus log to the base e into x will be equal to 1 plus log of x. This y will go on this side will be multiplied with this value 1 plus log of x into y, as we know log to the base ln of e is equal to 1. So in place of 1 we write log of e. Then dy over dx will be equal to e to the power x, because y is equal to e to the power x into log of e plus log of x. Now this can be written as log e to the power x log of e x. Here log of e plus log of x will be equal as log of a plus log of b is equal to log of a b. So log of e plus log of x will be equal to log e x. Example 2, find dy over dx if y is equal to sine raised to the power 3 of x. As y is equal to sine cube of x, then dy over dx. Now by taking the derivative on both sides, dy over dx, we get here d by dx of sine of cube x. So first we can take the derivative with respect to power, then we get 3 times sine square x into d by dx of sine of x. So dy over dx will be equal to 3 times sine square x into cos of x. This will be equal to 3 times sine square x into cos of x. Example 3. Now find the dy over dx if y is equal to under root of x dividing by sine of under root x. Solution. Now taking the derivative on both sides, dy over dx will be equal to d by dx of under root sine of x dividing by sine of under root x. So by taking we have to take the differential of this function by using the quotient rule. whereas quotient rule is equal to the denominator, it means sine of under root x into derivative of the numerator minus numerator into derivative of the denominator and denominator squared dividing by denominator squared. So this will be equal to sine of under root x into d by dx of sine x whole power half, means under root of x will be half, sine of x power half, minus under root sine of x into d by dx of sine into under root x dividing by sine of x under root x. Now this will be equal to sine of x, sine of under root x into the derivative of half sine power half will be equal to 1 by 2 sine x whole power 1 by 2 minus 1 into d by dx of sine x minus sine under root x into cos under root sine under root sine x into cos under root x into d by dx of under root x and whole dividing with sine under root x whole square. Now it will be equal to sine of x, sine of under root x into 1 by 2 sine of sine power minus half into cos of x minus sine under root sine x into cos under root x into 1 by 2 x raised to the power minus half dividing by sine under root x whole square. Sine, it will be equal to sine under root x into cos x. Sine under root x into cos x, then 1 by 2 sine power minus half will go to the denominator, will be equal to 2 times sine under root x, and minus this term will be equal to minus 2 minus sine of x under root sine of x into cos of under root x, and minus half 1 by 2 x to the power minus half will be equal to 2 in dividing by under root x and whole dividing by sine of under root x whole square. Now it will be equal, taking LCM on LCM as 2 under root sine x into under root x on the numerator. The numerator, this two values of the numerator by taking the LCM 2 times sine x under root sine x into under root x, we get this under root is multiplied with sine of x, so we'll get sine x into sine of under root x into cos x under root sine x sine under root x into sine of under root x into cos x minus under root sine x into under root, because under root sine x is multiplied with under root sine x, because we have take the derivative denominator, take the LCM as under root x into sine under root sine x, then it will be equal to sine x under root sine x into under root sine x into cos of under root x. So finally we get under root x into cos x into sine of under root x minus sine x into cos of under root x dividing by 2 times under root x into sine of under root x into sine under root sine x into sine under root x whole square. Let us take another example. Find the dy over dx if y is equal to 1 minus cos hyperbolic x dividing by 1 plus sine hyperbolic x. Now as we have given y is equal to 1 minus cos hyperbolic x dividing by 1 plus cos hyperbolic x. Now by using, we have to take the derivative of the above equation, above function. Now we can choose the quotient rule. So the dy over dx will be equal to the denominator 1 plus cos hyperbolic x into derivative of the numerator minus numerator times the derivative of denominator dividing by the denominator squared. So it will remain same, 1 plus cos hyperbolic x, and the derivative of 1 minus cos hyperbolic x will be equal to, because the derivative of 1 is 0 and sine hyperbolic x will be equal to derivative of sine hyperbolic x, will cos hyperbolic x will be equal to sine hyperbolic x, the minus sign remains, the negative sign remains negative, and minus 1 minus cos hyperbolic x into d by dx 1 d by dx of 1 plus cos hyperbolic x will be equal to sine hyperbolic x, because the derivative of 1 is 0 and derivative of cos hyperbolic x is sine hyperbolic x. Now we get 1 plus cos hyperbolic x into sine into minus sine hyperbolic x minus 1 minus cos hyperbolic x into sine hyperbolic x dividing by 1 plus cos hyperbolic x square. It will be equal to, now multiplying this minus sine hyperbolic with this, we get minus sine hyperbolic x and sine hyperbolic minus cos hyperbolic x and minus cos hyperbolic x into sine hyperbolic x. Now minus 1 is multiplied with sine hyperbolic x, it will be equal to minus sine hyperbolic x, and into minus minus plus will be equal to cos hyperbolic x into sine hyperbolic x dividing by 1 plus cos hyperbolic x whole square. Now the first term, the second term and the fourth term will be cancelled out with each other, and we get minus 2 times sine hyperbolic x dividing by 1 plus cos hyperbolic x whole square. So we get dy over dx equals 2 times minus 2 times sine hyperbolic x dividing by 1 plus cos hyperbolic x whole square. Now using the half angle identities, we get sine hyperbolic x is equal to 2 times sine hyperbolic x by 2 into cos hyperbolic x by 2, and 1 plus cos hyperbolic x by 2 x will be equal to 2 times cos hyperbolic square x by 2. So the above equation, above derivative dy by dx will be equal to 2 times, now putting the value of sine hyperbolic inverse sine hyperbolic x as the 2 times sine hyperbolic x by 2 into cos hyperbolic x by 2, or dividing by 1 plus cos hyperbolic x by x will be equal to 2 times cos hyperbolic x cos square hyperbolic x by 2 and whole power 2. So this 2 become 4, and this these 2 are cancel. Denominator and numerator has same constant 2 and it is 4. So we get sine hyperbolic x by 2 into cos hyperbolic x by 2 dividing by cos hyperbolic 4x by 2, and 1x is 1 cos hyperbolic x is cancelled out, and we get cos 3 hyperbolic x by 2 will be equal to sine hyperbolic x by 2 dividing by cos cube hyperbolic x by 2. Then this will be equal to sine hyperbolic x by 2 into cos hyperbolic x by 2 into cos square hyperbolic x by 2. Now sine hyperbolic x by 2 and cos hyperbolic x by 2 becomes tangent hyperbolic x by 2, and 1 by cos square hyperbolic x by 2 will be equal to secant hyperbolic square x by 2, and which is the required answer of this derivative.